Let's do some examples of the writing expressions with variables exercise. So it says write an expression to represent 11 more than a. Well, you could just have a, but if you want 11 more than a, you would want to add 11. So you could write that as a plus 11. You could also write that as 11 plus a. Both of them would be 11 more than a. So let's check our answer here. We got it right. Let's do a few more of these. Write an expression to represent the sum of d and 9. So the sum of d and 9, that means you're going to add d and 9. So I could write that as d plus 9, or I could write that as 9 plus 9 plus d. Check our answer. Got that right. Let's do a few more of these. Write an expression to represent j minus 15. Well, I could just write it in with math symbols instead of writing the word minus. Instead of writing minus, I could write j minus 15. And then I check my answer and got it right. Let's do a few more of these. This is a lot of fun. Write an expression to represent 7 times r. Well, 7, there's a couple ways I could do it. I could use this little dot right over here. I could do 7 times r like that. That would be correct. I could literally just write 7r. If I just wrote 7r, that would also count. Let me check my answer. That's right. Let me do a couple of other of these just so you can see that I could have just done 10. And this is not a decimal. This is, you know, it sits a little bit higher than a decimal. It's multiplication. And the reason why once you start doing algebra, you use this symbol instead of that kind of cross for multiplication is that x looking thing gets confused with x when you're using x as a variable. So that's why this is a lot more useful. So we want to write 10 times u. 10 times u. Let's check our answer. Got it right. Let's do one more. Write an expression to represent 8 divided by d. So you could write it as 8, and then I could write the slash like that, 8 divided by d. And there you go. This is 8 divided by d. Let me check the answer. I'll do one more of these. Oh, 6 divided by b. All right, same thing. So 6, I could use this tool right over here. It does the same thing as if I were to press the backslash. So 6 divided by b. Check my answer. Got it right.